Hey, what's going on, everybody? Your boy DJ City Manos, and in this video, let's talk about some stuff. Actually, let's talk about some stuff. What I'm gonna do? I'm still like in my gig for a couple weeks, and it got canceled. They just called me, text me, and they're gonna cancel. So for me, I was like, I'm not disappointed, but I'm like, okay, that's fine. The reason why I'm not disappointed because I'm at the point where I'm still, you know, like leaning towards quitting. I love playing music. Don't get me wrong. I love playing music. I'm not going to quit playing music. But just carrying the equipment and doing all kind of, you know, that's a little too much now for me. Like, let's say, maybe I even might join a group, like a DJ, what is it, a company, and just have them do all the work and just show up and play music and go home. We'll see. But I haven't decided yet. I just don't like, there's a lot of stuff behind the scenes that people don't know what, you know, DJs do. But in the meantime, this is what I'm going to do right now since, my party got canceled. And it was kind of interesting because I was questioning the event because it was, I did a party in the January. It was an indoor. I don't know if you guys remember that video where it was indoors. They had no furniture and they took all the furniture off in the living room. And they told me they're in the process of moving. So when they call me up again and they say, we're going to do another one, I'm like, dang, this is so soon? Because it's supposed to be this month on the 20th, I think it's the 28th. Let me see the calendar. Where's the calendar at? I don't know where my calendar go. Here it is. No. My calendar is not popping up. Yeah, the 25th. It's supposed to be on the 25th. And they told me that they're in the progress of moving and that they'll let me know as soon as they get all settled for the date change. So I kind of already knew that they were moving because when I was talking to the husband, he was saying that we're going to move in when they get to the new house. They're going to do a warm house party, I guess. And that's when she texted me and said, we're going to do it on February. And I was like, oh, I thought you guys were moving. But I guess there was like a conflict right there with scheduling. So that's fine. It's no problem for me. So I just go ahead. I just went ahead and removed her date. So now I'm available for that date if somebody calls me. But so in the meantime, on February 11th, I did the gig, right? Here was her playlist that she sent me. I'm going to keep the playlist. Like I said, this is a lot of good stuff right there. A lot of good music. I'm just going to tag them. That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to tag these. She got a lot of funk, man. She asked for a lot of funk. This is her stuff that she asked for. You know, you can see that she asked for bounce, rock, and roll, shake, and roll. She asked for Mr. Groove, So Rough, So Tough, you know. But even the cumbias, I'm going to get the cumbias. And here's another thing what I noticed. Let's put it in order, in alphabetical order. She asked for Fito. Where's Fito at? Right here. She asked for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And that night, I didn't even play. Maybe I played two Fito's songs. But I'm gonna work on a straight Fito mix. Straight, you know, maybe 10 songs, 8 songs. Just straight up Fito. That's what I'm going to do. Get it prepared. So next time when people ask me for Fito, I'm just going to go straight to the Fito mix. You know, because he does have a lot of good music, man. He has a lot of good stuff. And then from there, I'm going to work on a couple more mixes, organize my crates, because the crates, like I said, I don't use it for a lot of people use it for different reasons. My reason is just to put my mixes in there. And to me, it's let me explain. It's like a CD. So let's say you grab a CD, right? Pretend this is a CD. Let's open up this party mix. So let's say this is a CD, right? I'm going to grab this CD right here, and here goes all the songs that's in the CD. That's the way I do it. I do, like, little mixes, you know. So, and I want to work on these because sometimes I change them around, and this CD doesn't work right no more. That mix doesn't work out right no more. So, like, I got a lot of stuff that I got to start getting rid of. I'm going to organize it a little bit better. And that's the way I do it. That's the way I do things. It works out for me. A lot of people have different ways of doing stuff. Like right here, it says wedding songs. I don't have it. Let me see what's in there. So if I do a wedding, I guess I just made this wannabe mix. I call it wannabe mixes. I have that wannabe song in there. Let's see if it's in there still. here's that song, but I took that out of the mix. See, the thing is not matching no more because I used the songs for other mixes. So this mixes don't work out no more. If I would try to do it again, I don't even remember what order that I did it in. So this right here, I'm going to either get rid of it, get rid of this folder because it doesn't go together. And I might do a mix with Spice Girls in it, you know, or I might throw that song in some other mix, you know. So that's what I'm going to start doing. I'm going to start cleaning up my stuff. I see that I have Celebration, Billie Jean. At that time when I played this, it worked out pretty good. But now I got it all scrambled now. It doesn't, like it's 2, 3. I don't know if I played TikTok after this one. I can't remember no more. See, it's all over the place. It's just all, I'm going to start getting rid of stuff like that. This one too, I call it the cha-cha mix. Now I just added so many songs in there and it's all a mess. I'm going to clean it all up. But I don't remember before I used to put Blur Lines in there. And after Blur Lines, I threw in Uptown Funk. And after Uptown Funk, I threw in Cha-Cha Slide. So this is all just all scattered all over the place again. I'm going to fix this. I just got things all over the place, you know. And I'm going to start cleaning up my mixes. Right here, I see that I played You Should Be Dancing. And then I threw in Michael Jackson. And then I put Good Vibration. And then I put Gonna Make You Sweat. So these right here might still work together. This mix probably still work together. So I'm going to start getting things and start fixing things a little better. You know, and that's what I do. That's what I just, when I do mixes, I put songs in there that sounds good and I take them out. Like when she asked for a song, when she requested a song, where's her playlist at? I look at it and I see, I don't want to redo the whole mix all over again. I say, you know what? I got this song in the mix. Let's say I'm going to do September. I say, I got September in the mix somewhere. And the only thing I got to do is just look for that crate. it's like I said, it's like a CD. Look for the CD. And then it has my mix all lined up, ready to go, you know. If not, I just create a new mix, you know. So most of these stuff, I already have them already in mixes. I just got to look for them. And then from there, it's all, you know, I just make a folder for her. Here goes her folder down here. The date is all wrong. It says February 1, but actually it was the 11th. So I really didn't trip off of that. I know that this is hers. And this is some of the songs she asked for. She asked for Pepas, right? So right here, I know that the song's in here. So I grabbed that crate, this folder, and threw it in there. You know, and there's some other songs in there, some other extra stuff. So if I want to keep going with the mix, I keep going. So I think I stopped it right here. Oh, no, I stopped right here. Tita me pregunto. I stopped it there. So, you know, you got to decide. You want to keep going or stop it. And this one, I play this one. The color is kind of dark. You can't really see what's in the songs because it's dark. But I think I stopped. I let this one go. I went all the way to Café con Leche. I think I went. No, I stopped on the anthem. No. My bad. I didn't stop on the anthem. I stopped on the bonbon. I'm trying to figure out. Yeah, so, you know, sometimes I stop or I keep going. I look at the dance floor, see what's happening. If nobody dancing, then I stop it. Like, if you watch that video that I upload on YouTube, the raw footage of the funk, if you notice when I slapped on what is it called, bandolet or whatever, you notice that everybody pretty much cleared the dance floor. I made the decision to, I said, you know what, I'm going to stop the mix here, and I'm going to start off with a new mix. So, you know, that's what I do. Well, if I see the dance floor is dying, I change it. I try to grab them back on the dance floor. A lot of people, when I go in the mix, I play like 8 songs. If you notice, those mixes are pretty long. they run for at least 20 minutes, more than 20 minutes. And if you're out there on the dance floor dancing, man, that's a long time of dancing, you know. And you always have to want to break it up, you know, like put a slow song in between or something. I always save the requests for that reason. Like if I have to go to the bathroom or something, I just throw in the request in there, or I got to go get something to drink. I just give them a break, you know, give people a break, you know, just always let them know that you're going to continue the mix after this short break or whatever. And to play the request real quick. So I got some mixes to fix up. This is a bunch of mixes right here that I did, a bunch of them. Like this one's a mix. I got to clean it up because there you see different colors. So I probably put them in there for like a temporary. like they probably asked for it. I gotta sneeze. They had probably asked for it, El Paso del Gigante, this one I hear, and I threw it in there because in the mix I just grabbed this mix and said, you know what, let's throw it in there. You know, there's no reason, so I might take it out again and fix it up, or I might make this one into two mixes because I noticed that there's 19 songs in here, so I might break it up to two mixes because it's pretty long. You know, well, we got Sally, that girl. I'm going to clean this one up. I'm going to fix this one up. She asked for Tootsie Roll. I didn't like the verse that I got. I didn't realize it. They just keep on repeating, to the left, to the left. They didn't have no rapping in it, so I'm going to grab this one, look for this one again. And I like the way it came out. See the way I had after Control, I think I stopped the mix there. But I could have put Missy Elliott, Lose Control, after that one, Lolly. And then I had Low Flow Rider, and then Wild Thing, and It's Tricky. I had it all ready to go. But now, I'm not sure if I'm going to keep it like this. I might just keep it like that for now. If you notice, after this one here, it says 4, and then 5. You could actually put 4.1, 4.2. So when you hit the order part, it comes through all in order. You know, like I said, I don't like to go... once I start going to 12 songs mix, you know, I don't know. I like to keep it 8 songs, maybe 10 songs to max. Like I said, if I see people still grooving, I keep it going. If I don't see people dancing anymore, I cut it off and do something else. So, yeah, I'm going to, right now, in the meantime, since I ain't got nothing going on, I'm just going to start organizing my my crates. You know, right here, look at this Tootsie Slide. Then I went to Lucid Dreams, Heartless. So at that time, when I did this mix, maybe some of these songs were requested. So, like, I do all these little mixes, you know. I don't know what's going on. And I give it a title, like a weird title, like What's Popping, you know. That song, What's Popping, should be in this mix, but it's not. Usually I name it to what the name of a song is. You know, Wobbles, I know the Wobbles, the song. Scrub, I don't know Scrubs in there. Started from the Bottom, you know, that song Started from the Bottom is in there. So I just gave it a title so I know what kind of genre it is. You know, I just don't put 105 beats per minute mix. No, I don't do that. I just put a title in there. So they say they want hip-hop. I already know What's Popping's up hip-hop. This is hip-hop, hip-hop. You know, Boogie Shoes, I know that's like a disco song. So I know this is like more funk disco, you know. And if you see what I was going to put Blur Lines, and after Blur Lines, I was going to slap. See the way somebody suggested this song right here, Gotta Give It Up. So I had these two ready in there in the mix. So after Boogie Shoes, if the party kept going, I was going to slap on Blur Lines. I was going to put Boogie Shoes, and then I was going to slap on Blur Lines afterwards. So yeah, the beats per minute is the same. So right here, this cue mark, I was going to get ready with Blur Lines if I see people still dancing. So let's see what it sounds like. Here we go. You know, I was going to do some crazy stuff like that. And then somebody suggested this one by Marvin Gaye, Gotta Give It Up. And that's the same, basically the same music, the same beat, everything. So the only thing I need to do is adjust the beats per minute to 120. And it goes perfect, you know, like. So I like that. When you guys give me the suggestions, I'm like, that's pretty good that you guys gave me some ideas that I wouldn't have done. And I like this. I like that you guys gave me some suggestions. So let's move this to 09. That's close enough. So let's go to this cue mark and let's see what it sounds like. Yo, hair like so I jail watch, hand wait for you to salute, chew, dip, tip. Not many women can refute, dip, tip, and I'm a nice guy, but don't get a confused. Old school. You're listening to DJ Cinema Live in the Mix. Gotta give it up. Now this, I won't let it go that long. I'm gonna show you guys how to cut it shorter. I'm gonna show you how to do this shorter. Watch this. It's gonna be right on point. Watch this. Right here. Let me back it up. Right here. I want to cut it off right here. So, right here, I'm going to put a cue mark where it tells me to end it. So, I'm going to put it right here, end or cut. I'm going to put cut right here because you want to cut it real quick. Just cut it. And I'm going to make this into a marker. This one right here. And then you notice that this one doesn't even say end. I'm going to end it right here. Like I said, I do things different, a little different. I don't be counting beats, man. For me, this is so much easier. So right here, I'm going to cut it in. And so watch this song right here. Watch this one. I'm going to get it when he starts singing. So right here, it's supposed to be the end, but check this out. Watch this, watch this. He starts singing like after a few beats later, watch. Actually, right here, he starts singing. So we're going to try this out and see what it sounds like. I'm going to try to get it on the money. On the money. So right here, I'm going to put a, I'm going to go to beat jump on both of these. I'm going to go to beat jump. And I'm going to go back. I'm going to go back up beats until I get to the beginning on blur lines. Keep going. And I'm going to stop on blur lines when I hit end, when I see end. So I'm doing both of them at the same time. And here comes end. And one more. Boom. So right here on Got to Give It Up, that's going to be the starting point right there. So I'm going to delete this cue mark on Got to Give It Up. And I'm going to put a new cue point right there. So it won't be too long. So when it went boom, that could be the, I'm going to hear it again. Yeah, I'm going to leave it like that. We're going to see what it sounds like. Alright, so let's go. Now you start turning up the volume a little bit more. Now, it sounded okay. It sounded pretty good. You can't really tell. Let's try it again. When you cannot tell that you're blending a new song, man, just leave it alone. Leave it alone. So let's hear it one more time. So that right there, I'm going to leave this alone. I might even get rid of this one here, Justin Timberlake. So I might start off with She's a Bad Mama Jamma, Ladies Night, get Down on It, Uptown Funk, Boogie Shoes, Blurred Lines, and Gotta Give It Up. So this right here is 8 songs. If I get rid of this one, it'll be 7 songs. So I'm going to keep hold on to this for now. I just got some things to clean up. So for now, before I take off, I want to introduce you guys to a video I want you guys to watch. Watch this video right here. His name is Chris Mears. It's called 5 DJ Habits to Level Up in 2023. Watch this video. This is pretty good. It got a lot of good information. And I agree with him 100% on what he's saying. He gets a little technical. He gets a little crazy, like get a calendar out and do it for 30 days and, you know, blah, blah, blah. That's a, for me, it's just like, just have fun. But watch this video and see if you agree with it. I agree with it 100%. He's just basically saying people need to start getting out of their little comfort zone. So let's say I'm just a hip-hop DJ, you know, and that's my specialty, hip-hop. He's just saying try something else, try a different genre, try playing some different kind of music, you know, get out of your comfort zone. And he's just saying practice, get a start off with five songs and practice those songs for 30 minutes. I don't know what he said, but just perfect it, and then later on you get used to that genre. He said try different stuff. Like right now I just got through mixing Blur Lines, since it has that give it up, gotta give it up beat to it. It goes good with the old school funk music, you know. You gotta try something different. You gotta try something. I mix cumbias. If I had to stick with cumbias and say, you know, I don't like reggaeton or whatever, but I be mixing cumbias with reggaeton. I mix banda with merengue. I mix disco with house. I mix, you know, rock music with, you know, just, he's just saying try different genres and blend them together and play with other songs, you know. And this way he said, I forgot what he said. I think he said that you'll get more business or something, or you get into the clubs a little bit more because you have different style of music. Like if you're in a club, they ask for, a lot of people ask for different kind of music. And if you only specialize on house or EDM or whatever, and somebody come up and ask for a pop song, you'd be like, well, it's pop. I don't really play pop, you know. I'm going to give you another example. This one DJ on YouTube was bragging that he could mix a song within, 15 seconds or whatever. He could blend them and that he perfected and stuff. And I just, you know, I didn't want to be a butthead, but I wanted to just have fun with him and see what he says. And I told him, I said, that's pretty cool that you could mix, like get it on the money now, your mixes or whatever. And I say, have you ever tried a different genre? He goes, I'm sure I won't have no problem with it. So I gave him two songs. I said, here, try to blend these two songs together. He messaged me back and he goes, yeah, I'm not too familiar with those songs. So he was mixing a lot of EDM, a lot of house. And for me, the beat never really varies like hip-hop. Hip-hop also varies. The beats per minute just go up and down. On hip hop, even the old and the 90 hip hop. Let me try something. Let me see. I'm gonna try to see if I can find anything. I don't want to make this video too long, but I just want to see if I can find something that, if I could catch something that changes beat. Like this is 99 beats per minute. This is 99. Actually, this one's 90, 100 beats per minute. But we're gonna match it anyways. I'm gonna 91. Okay, see, I got it right there, 99.91. So let's see if it drifts off, all right? That's what I want to see. All right, I want to see if it drifts off. All right, so right away, the grid's off, right? I could put the grid together. Let's put the grid together. Oops, wrong one. So now the grid is lined up. And what I always look at, I don't even look at the grid. I just look at the top row. And I'm trying to look at the wave and see where they hit at. So right here, it hits on the money. That hits on the money. Hits on the money. I don't see anything that's drifting. So this one was probably not a good example. That both of them playing at the same time. Yeah, they're both basically on the money. This one's on the money. But there are some hip hop that do drift. And that guy, when he was bragging about it, most of the house, like, I don't see it drifting too much. It's always on the beat. The grid's the same. So it's probably easy for him. He probably got used to that genre. And always challenge yourself. Challenge yourself. Grab a different genre. And, you know, if you already perfect that one right there, grab with something different. Grab some pop. Grab something that has singing in it. Because EDM and house, it really doesn't have much singing in it. Grab something different. That's what in the video he's talking about. He says, grab different genres, play with other stuff, improve your skills. And I agree with it. I was like, dang, that's pretty good. Because I've been doing that forever. I've been playing different genres together. Not a lot, but I do mix a lot of different stuff. I mix new stuff with the old stuff. Even with the hip hop, I might grab an old hip hop, mix it with the new hip hop. You know, it's fun to play with different stuff. And that's what he's just saying on the video. So just watch this video. This video is very interesting. It just popped up on my thing and I started watching it. So watch it and see if you agree with it. And this is your boy, DJ City Manos, and I got some cleaning to do. Crates cleaning. I'm out. Peace.